Rich Russell and Dave Brown right along the ringside, and a bunch of great folks lined up here for our championship wrestling this week. Looks like another good one, Dave.
Boy, great card coming up. We've got the superstar, Bill Dundee, be involved in the opening match today. Sure, Billy Travis is here. Dirty Rhodes back in the area. I think most of the wrestling fans remember him. Yeah, he's back. Dutch Mantel will be here. Nature Boy, Buddy Landel. But the one I'm waiting for is an eight-man tag team match. It's going to be the Sheepherders, Tony Falk, and Pat Rose on one side. On the other side, it is going to be Coco Ware, Rick Casey, and the Fantastics.
Ooh, how about that, sports fans? You better believe a big eight-man tag is our expiration of time. In addition to that, we're going to be having information regarding the contest, a date with the Fantastics. Yeah. We'll get to that a little bit later on. Right now, timeout. We'll be back with the opening bout with Bill Dundee and Jim Jameson in just a moment.
Entertainment.
Okay, we're going to be ready to go here with our opening bout. Bill Superstar Dundee, the Southern Heavyweight Champion, coming out.
I need to talk to you, Bill? And I know it's early in the morning. Some of you ladies are sitting over there looking at a little bowl of grits, and there's a big fat redneck sitting across the table from you, and you said, oh my God, I gotta look at him every. But no, you don't. You just look at the TV set, and you're looking at the living legend and the superstar, and I know I'm making your day. And tonight you're gonna go home with your old man, and he's gonna get all loving, and you're gonna be thinking of the superstar because you saw him first thing this morning. But I'm supposed to climb in this ring right now and wrestle Jim Jameson.
I'm glad you know that. We've got a match coming
up. That ain't going to take place, because when you're the living legend, the superstar, and the Southern Heavyweight Champion, you get a little pool around here, and I ain't wrestling Jim Jameson. You know why, Lance Russell? Because it would be boring, boring, boring. But I got something else for you now. All week long since I beat up Big Red Reese, the people that like the whales have been calling me insane, and the people that are cruelty to animal people have been calling up and saying, Superstar, why did you beat on that big whale like that? I didn't beat on him too bad, so I got me a little tape, and I'm going to show it to you all. And last week, I invited Buddy Landel over to my house and Dirty Dutch Mantel, because your commentary was horrible on that, Lance Russell. You wasn't telling the people how it was. So when they come over to my private screening room, Buddy Landel sat there, I sat in the middle, Dirty Dutch Mantel. We re-commentated the match. Now, if you talk to the man upstairs, he'll show it to you, and we'll see what you did last week.
Okay, keep your finger on the audio. You don't know what's going to be. Have we got it? Okay, let's take a look at it.
All right, you folks in Memphis, you would all like to be here, but you can't be here because the superstar of the living legend, the Nature Boy, and the Dutchman's here, all my friends in my personal viewing room, my little library at my home here. And we've taken this opportunity because I have been getting bombarded with letters from the people that get mad at you if you're cruel to animals. Now, you know, and a whale's an animal. You know, I know you. Most people think animals is four-legged people, but they ain't. Whales are animals. They're mammals. They suckle the young. That's what makes you an animal. People are animals. So they've been calling me up and writing me letters about being bad to Big Red. Well, I was, you know, he is a whale of a man, right, Budger? What would you
That's
think?
Right, Bill. What's it feel like to have so many titles? You're the Southern Heavyweight Champion, the living legend, and now the giant killer, brother.
Oh, I never thought of that, Budger. That's a good line, the giant killer. But the main thing that we're here, folks, is because, Dutchman, you know, you've read some of the letters. They were mad at us because we were beating up on a whale-type man. You know, if we'd been real bad, what would we done to him? We would have harpooned him, wouldn't we? There's the telephone ringing. It's probably Britt Eklund, or it's probably what's it calling you, Nature Boy. It never quits here, folks. I'm telling you, it's terrible to be a sex symbol, ain't it, Budger?
It's hell, brother. The trouble me, you, and Tom Selleck have with our women, we could write novels about it.
Dutchman, what do you think? You were there. You saw this in live and loving color. You only came down at the end of this match to pull me off him, didn't you?
To pull you off him. You know, a lot. You remember that whale in California that kept going up the sound and kept getting lost, and they kept trying to turn him loose and trying to shoot him back to the ocean? People wonder what happened to him. Well, you see right there, that big thing in the green, that big blob there, is the whale that finally went to the ocean and then come back as a wrestler. And Bill, you got him in the ring right there. I mean, we're going to show the people the difference.
Jack Corday had a green suit made for him. He changed his name to Big Red. They saved that whale, folks. Now you're looking at
it.
Budrow, we'll take a little rest here because strategy is the main thing when you're wrestling a giant, ain't it? You got to have him on your grounds. And we have him here. Big Red's all anxious, wants to go, but we're just going to tire him out a little bit. Big Red, look at that. He looks like a big old leprechaun right there. Some people, no class, they're yelling for the superstar.
Now, see, he's even got his colors messed up. See, Big Red, but he's got a green outfit on. That don't even make sense at all.
He's talking to Blender, don't he?
Well, yeah, he does. Now, here we go. Here's some people telling me, go ahead, Bill, kill him. But I don't want to do that because, like we said, folks, we just wanted to beat him up a little bit. We didn't want to hurt the whale. We would have harpooned him. Oh, good move there. Good technical wrestling move, Bud. What do you think? Good right hook. There's another good one. Oh, well, that was a flat of the foot. Oh, that's legal, folks. That's a good elbow right there. That's a cute little devil in that superstar outfit. Yes, it is. Oh, it's me.
He's sticking his head and running it right into your fist. So I can't understand that.
Now, here we go. Now, there's a dancing whale, folks. Classic example. He's either Kermit the Frog or a dancing whale. Looks more like Kermit in that outfit. Here we go now. Oh, Miss Piggy be coming down here in a minute. Tell us not to do it. Oh, there's Miss Piggy sitting right there, two of them. Just take another little rest here, Bud. Talk to them girls out there, Bud. Tell them how nice you are.
Well, it's obvious, superstar, that the reason why you're back and the reason why I'm here is because the women around the Memphis area and Nashville.
Excuse me for a minute, Bud. I thought you looked a little tired, so I just threw that chair in and I'm telling them, have a little rest, Big Red. Sit on it. Excuse me. Go ahead.
Well, as I was saying, it's obvious the women are starved for the sight of a real man, and we're talking about the epitome of manhood right here. Watch yourself, everybody. What's it like to see yourself beating a whale up on TV, huh?
Well, this is the first time I've ever wrestled Big Red, and the first time. Oh, good drop kick too. Yes, sir. Come here, Dutchman.
Yes, sir.
Come on down here, because you come down here to tell me. Look at this now. I think Big Red.
I should have come earlier.
That's when you should have come inside.
I was afraid the whale was going to die of cardiac arrest there, and I was getting concerned in the back because we really don't want to kill nobody. We just want to beat him up and humiliate him and run him out of town. You know who I'm talking about there.
Oh, yeah, he done good. What was his name, Jerry? What?
Jerry somebody. I can't remember his name.
Was it a wrestler around here, Jerry something?
Somewhere.
Had a silly hat, green and little red thing with stars instead of you.
Real margin, man.
Yeah, Jerry something. I don't know. He gone anyway. Run him out of town. Well, here we go now. I was just going to hold him down, give him mouth-to-mouth resuscitation because I thought he was going to die right then. Referee pulled me off him. Don't know why. Come on, Kermit, get up. Well, that's a technical wrestling move. I just helped him up the sole of my foot.
See how that weight shift when you kicked him in the side there, Bill?
looks like a waterbed. Oh, here we go. Kermit going to dance a little bit now. Buddy, this is Dutchman, come here, because just about the time you start to feel sorry for him, you come down and say, Bill, don't do it no more. That good right hook.
I wonder what size bra he wears. It looks like he just had a litter of puppies.
I know. Well, now that was an illegal blow. I don't know. The referee should have disqualified him right there. Five minutes. I thought we'd be sitting here a week. Just 5 minutes going past. Well, I'm the one thing. Jack Cousteau's got to be real nice to us from now on, because we could have harpooned this jerk anytime we wanted. Whoops. Oh, yeah, I'm telling you. Man, I'm so quick, brother. Me and Dutch, one time, we was laying in a hotel room in Louisiana, and we went to bed and flicked off the switch. Now, I said that all backwards. You tell them how we did it, Dutchman.
Well, we were so fast. Bill said hit the switch. We was in the bed half asleep while the room got dark. Now, I'm talking fast now.
Now, that's fast, bud. We're right behind. Now, this is it, Dutch. You feel real sore. You see he can't get up. Look, the man has just run out of whatever. It keeps us athletes going. Steam, I think. Now, look at that. See, now.
He hit me for no reason.
That's right, and a chain fell out of his back pocket, and I just happened to pick it up. Now, I'll give the man credit. He was a little smart here. He blocked that punch, and he knocked me down. I fell over, kind of slipped.
Now, look, he's trying to grab me.
Now, that's right, see?
He hit me, and he's still trying to.
Just like a whale. Whales are big and dumb. Otherwise, they wouldn't get harpooned so easy when them little guys went in them boats and them harpoons and did it. Now, here's the harpoon, brother. There he goes. 400 pounds of blubber there, folks. Going to turn them into whale oil.
You pull a whale off a beach.
That's right.
Get beached on the beach there.
There it is.
Two, three.
All over. That's right. Well, Jack Cousteau, we didn't hurt him up too bad. And all you whale lovers, there it is. Budra, say goodbye to the nice folk.
Bye.
I'm going to tell you, Lancer, that wasn't quite as boring as being a Jameson. But I just want to tell you all something. Want to tell all you people out there something. Buddy Landel, the Nature Boy, Dirty Dutch Mantel, and the Superstar, they ain't got nothing against fat people. They ought to take every one of you, lock you in a room, and make you listen to Jerry Lawler records. Well, folks, like I told you, we're going to take a little break now, because I'm taking over right here. Take a little break. We'll be back. Bye-bye.
Wednesday night in Evansville, let me tell you the main event. No time limit, no disqualification, Southern Heavyweight Championship. Can't believe the stipulation. Loser leaves town with Bill Superstar Dundee and Steve Keirn. Steve, I want to ask you first, how in the world did you get yourself in that type of situation? And more importantly, how did you get Dundee to sign the match?
Well, let me answer your question in a second, Randy. First of all, I'd like to say Happy New Year to all the fans from myself and from Stan and from Jackie Fargo. You know, we've been out of town for a few weeks, but we've been home in Florida visiting our relatives. Everybody likes to get home around their relatives or their friends for the holidays. It just so happens our home happens to be in Florida, so that's where we've been. Now, in the time that we were home in Florida, we heard about the upset where Dundee beat Lawler, and Lawler's left town. You know, I'd like to see that match myself just to see how that went, because I can't believe Dundee can beat Lawler in a fair and square match. But all that beside, I said to Eddie Marlin, I'd give anything to be in a match with Dundee again for that title, because I know how precious that title means to him. As cocky as he is and the way he wears it and walks around, I said, what can I do? Well, a few phone calls back and forth, and he says, if you'll agree to leave town, if you lose the match, you can have it. I said, well, I'd like a little bit more. So Eddie Marlin calls me back about 3 or 4 days later and says, you're not going to believe what I got, Steve. He says, I've got a loser leave town. Whoever loses the match leaves town, including Dundee. He came in, looked at the contract, read the first few lines that said, Bill Dundee, Steve Keirn leaves town, Bill Dundee keeps the belt. Oh, that's all he read. He went right on past the second paragraph, signed his name, real cocky-like. Well, let me tell you, Bill Dundee, for being so smart and being so cocky, you fail to read the part that says if you lose, you not only lose your title, but you got to pack your bags and leave town. Well, that's the part that I like, because I'm not only going to beat you for that title, I'm going to run you right out of here. You're real cocky with that belt around your waist and a king on the pile, but it's all over.
Referee Jerry Calhoun is in the ring, and we're set to go with one fall, 15-minute time limit match. Introducing from parts unknown at 216 pounds, the Invader. And going against him at a total weight of 230 pounds from Hamden, Connecticut, Billy Travis. This match will be one fall, 15-minute time limit.
Okey-doke, the jacket of Travis coming off, and we're about ready to get into the live action. Here it goes. Bell has sounded. One fall, 15 minutes. Travis and the Invader going at it.
Billy Travis. Ooh, wrapping up the arm. Good moves by Travis as the Invader tried to reverse him and grab the advantage, perhaps with a top wrist lock, but Travis held on. Invader on the mat, slides under the ropes. Referee there calls for a break. Billy Travis with a weight advantage on the Invader. Now the Invader bounces to his feet after a clean takedown and starts complaining to the referee that he had his tights pulled. Look at Travis move. Very agile wrestler, Billy Travis.
You know, I was doing a match that Travis was involved in, maybe a week or 2 weeks ago or so, and made the comment that I think one of the greatest assets that Travis has, he has a lot of the physical attributes and he learns fast, and he's still a young wrestler. I mean, when you consider he won the Rookie of the Year, the international wrestling fans, last year, as a matter of fact. But Billy's confidence stands him in good stead. He is a kind of a guy who thinks he can win every single match that he goes out there, and he always has been that way.
That's true, yeah, and that's most important in a match, I guess, in any sporting event, to have the confidence to think you can go out there and to wrestle with the best of them in this case. He's always had it, as you say, and no doubt he's got it today. He's got that arm wrapped up real well, really putting pressure on the Invader's left arm. Something a little extra.
Travis in command as he has the arm bar with the hand right at the shoulder to put the extra emphasis on it. Invader coming back up to his feet. Looks like he's getting ready to nail him one. Muscles Travis back to the corner. The referee calls for a break. They don't look like they're responding too fast.
You know, we're talking about confidence. This Invader comes in with confidence, too. We've seen him in some tough matches. He just had his confidence shaken a bit by Travis. Travis with the body slam leaves the Invader in the middle of the ring. Drops down with the lower leg.
Travis is another one that has no hesitation. If it calls for using the fist, he will, in fact, use it. Billy's a lot better than he used to be in that respect, though. Chin lock. Knee planted in the spine of the Invader as he pulls back.
Reader back up on his feet. Billy Travis still had the arm barred. Invader swinging that right fist. Billy Travis stopped him and returns the right fist himself. Now has the Invader in the air. Drew thought he was going to put him in the turnbuckle, but he dropped him down with a backbreaker. Travis springs off the rope, drops down, covers, count is two, and now three, and it's over. 3 minutes, 15 seconds. Billy Travis with a good win.
Good, solid execution by Travis as he takes the Invader in, what,
3:15.
3:15 for Travis. Had an interesting tag match that we wanted to share some of the highlights toward the end of the match with, Dave. It involved the Bladerunners, Borden and Hellwig, going against the team of Billy Travis and Phil Hickerson. I think noteworthy, if they, everybody will keep their eye on the monitor or their set, they will see the reuniting of what was formerly a very tough tag team in Hickerson and the Spoiler. Take a look at this. Referee got his hands full. Bladerunners. Uh-oh. Phil really creased. Oh, man. He just knocks the breath totally out of you. He's falling.
Coming up Wednesday night, Evansville Coliseum. Son of a gun, I'll tell you, there are five matches on the card, and every one of them you are going to enjoy. Take a listen to this. Bill, the Bladerunners going against Billy Travis and the Spoiler. There's going to be a pledge match in there with the Fantastics going against the Sheepherders. Mid-America Heavyweight Championship match. Nature Boy, Buddy Landel will be trying tough Coco Ware. You're going to see an international title match going on when two Texans, Rick Casey, challenges Dutch Mantell for the international title. And then here it is, the Southern Heavyweight Belt on the line. No time, no disqualification, going to be a winner. The loser leaves town. That's what the stipulations say. Steve Keirn will be going against Bill Dundee, friend, and one of them will be saying bye-bye, Evansville, Indiana. Five big matches, all of that taking place in the Coliseum, Evansville, Indiana. Make it a point to make the trip. Be there.
You know, Davey, with Jerry Lawler having left the area, not by choice, It opens up a very large hole, and there's a lot of major wrestlers that are interested in filling the spot of that guy.
You're right. All of them interested in it. Coming
Austin
right in
Idol here. Is yeah. one of those fellas. He's talking about the kid is hot tonight. I wonder if he's putting out a prophecy right there. Austin Idol. The ring right now, a new team to our championship wrestlers, the Raiders. And here's a new team. It's not new wrestlers, but they are a new team. Dave, here's the official introduction.
All right, it's a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match. Introducing first from parts unknown at 453 pounds total weight, the Raiders. And going against them at a total of 501 pounds from Japan, Tojo Yamamoto, his partner from Austin, Texas, Dirty Rhodes. This match will be one fall, 15-minute time limit, and the referee is Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, the Raiders will be taking our first look at, as we said, bell time, and here we go, off and running as Dirty Rhodes will be starting out. He will be starting against the shorter of the two Raiders as... Dirty son of a gun, we love to see him. And one of the reasons is because he loves to wrestle.
He does indeed.
It comes through, I think you feel that.
He has fun, he has the confidence and the ability to be able to go in there and have a good time most of the time when he's in matches. He's in there against a team that we haven't seen before, the team of the Raiders. The Raiders come in here under the mask and giving away almost 50 pounds in total weight to the team of Tojo and Dirty Rhodes, both of whom are rather large gentlemen.
Making a tag, and the taller of the two Raiders makes his first appearance on championship wrestling. Good clean break as Dirty Rhodes comes flying off the ropes, hooks him up and tags Yamamoto almost in one same move, and Tojo with a couple of stinging chops getting the attention of Raider number two. Back on the ropes again, and Yamamoto cuts loose with a blistering chop. The referee was saying, be sure you don't hit him right across the throat. Center of the ring, the Raider to a top wrist lock. He's got the height advantage. That would be a good move, but it didn't stay very long.
Exactly. He has the height, and that's exactly where that standing wrist lock will work for you. But against Tojo, firing those chops, nothing much works except staying out of his way.
Yamamoto winds the arm up. Over in the corner, a tag, and Raider number one back in the ring again. Tojo hooks that arm, rolls him over, and slams him down. Drags him right out, but he's back up again. Tie up there above us on the ropes. and Yamamoto stung him. Boy, he wailed him with that chop, I want to tell you. Again, Tojo going with the chops to the back of the head. Puts the top of the foot to the midsection. Well, I'm not certain. He may have used the point of the toe on that.
Looked like he did with one of those. He did come back with the side of the foot to the midsection, too, after that. Joe, boy, he's really using that chop. Just knocking the Raider down to the mat. There's a tag on Dirty Rhodes, and look out. Dirty Rhodes. Off the ropes, drops down. I don't think he's going to get up. One, two. He doesn't. Count of three. 2 minutes, 54 seconds, and the team of Tojo Yamamoto and Dirty Rhodes dominating the match. Over the team, our first look at them, the Raiders, who come in here today against that formidable opposition and do not get out with anything. Well, they get out of here all right, but they certainly don't have the victory. The win goes to Dirty Rhodes, Tojo Yamamoto, 2 minutes, 53 seconds.
They came in here, Dave, I think, as most teams do, nervous on their first appearance on Championship Wrestling, and then face a couple of veterans like that. Son of a gun, they found out what it was like. We want to give you some information right now pertaining to the fantastic date with the Fantastics. And before we get into it, let's bring them on in here. Bobby Fulton, Tommy Rogers, the Fantastic. Tommy, wanted you guys to be out here because I know you're very excited about the information that we're getting ready to share with all of the wrestling fans, and I think the fans are going to be equally excited. Coming up, a contest. By golly, it's the first one we've had in a long, long time. Never had one exactly like this. We call it the Fantastic Date with the Fantastic, and it's an opportunity for a couple of the gals out there in the audience to have a chance to go out with the Fantastics on a date. If you guys will hold it just a second, let me give them the nuts and bolts, the details of how the contest works. Now, what we would like for all of you gals who are interested, first, you must be 18 years of age or older and single in order to enter the contest. We would like for you to submit a picture with a written statement of why I would like to have a date with the Fantastics in 100 words or less. Hold it. 100 words or less, why I would like to have a date with a Fantastic, and close it with your picture. Now, please, when you submit the picture and your written statement as to why you would like to have a date with a Fantastic, please enclose your address and your phone number so that we will have some way of getting in contact with you. Now, what's the prize? You got it, a fantastic date with these two great gentlemen here. It will consist of being picked up at your home in a beautiful limousine, taken out for a fine dinner with the Fantastics, taken down to the arena nearest your home, and you'll get a chance to enjoy the match there after spending a lovely evening with the Fantastics, and you are in for a real store. This will be a chaperone date on the Fantastic Date with the Fantastic, and the address for you to send your entry in is as follows: Fantastic Date, WMC-TV, 1960 Union Avenue, Memphis, Tennessee, 38104. Now, what we're going to ask you to do is be certain it is sent to Fantastics Date, WMC-TV. Be sure and put Fantastics Date on your address. We'll leave that up there for just a moment, a chance for you to get it down. But son of a gun, what a great opportunity. And I know there's going to be two gals out there. By the way, the decisions will be made by Young & Associates. They will be the ones that will be making the decision, not the Fantastics or anybody connected with the company. Young & Associates will be making the decision. A couple of gals are really going to be excited. I think you guys may be, too.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, we're real excited about this. This is going to be a big thrill for the Fantastics to get a chance to take two girls out. Well, if it was up to me and Tommy, we'd like to load all these girls up in the biggest limo in the world and take them all out on a date. But the way this is going, Mr. Russell, the way this is going is that there's going to be two winners in this date right when they send in a card.
Buddy, please, we've got something going on.
It's obvious that you can see why the women in Memphis, Nashville, and the surrounding areas would start with the sight of a real man, because look what all they got to look up to, huh?
Hey, I'm sorry about this. We were trying to explain about the fantastic date with the Fantastics, Buddy, and you have no interview scheduled out here at this time.
Well, I'm the nature boy. I take up time anytime I want to. Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. What gives them the audacity to come out there and call themselves the Fantastics just because they're one of the greatest tag teams around? They don't give them the right to come out here and mess with the heads of my women. Let me tell you something. If they can do it, so can the nature boy. Now, the nature boy, Buddy Landel, is going to have a date of a lifetime. All you have to do, forget the 50 words or less, all you got to do is send an 8x10 photocopy of your face to this TV station. Pop the address up there on the screen, Lance Russell. Get with it.
Well, okay.
You know, Lance, since I've been here, by the way, I have failed to see any good-looking women. Now, it's obvious when the nature boy goes at him like a magnet. I attract them everywhere I go. And I have to say, since I've been here, everything's been coming up a little bit. I have to pat myself on the back a little bit, but not too much.
Well, the address that we have, if we had any respondents to your particular one, would be the same thing. It would be WMC-TV 1960 Union Avenue. I don't know whether you want them to enter it in the Fantastic date or send it to the Buddy Landel date.
Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. If you'll go check the operator's switchboard right now, the whole thing's lighting up like a Christmas tree. It's pandemonium out there. It's Nature Boy Buddy Landel time around the Memphis area. Calm down, girls. You're going to get your chance, all right? And let me tell you something. What kind of stipulations do they have for their women? The only thing you got to do, girls, is send an 8x10 color photo of yourself, okay? Write your name, your address, your phone number on the back, and I call none. And I don't want...
They have to be 18 years or older and single for the Fantastic date.
That's okay for the Fantastics because they might get three or four sweat hogs to write them. But we're talking about the nature boy. We're talking about the difference between the minor leagues and the major leagues. Okay, Lance Russell, you know where I'm coming from? All right. Girls, when you get... If you win, if you get lucky enough to win the date with the nature boy, Buddy Landel, just being seen on my arm... Okay? Now, first off, I'm going to bring you on this TV station, which is the strongest wrestling television in the whole world, okay? Now, I know all the executives in Hollywood. I know all the art directors of Hollywood. I know them all, okay? Let me tell you something, Lance Russell. If the girl that wins the date, if she's lucky enough to win the date with the nature boy, Buddy Landel, if she's seen on this TV station with her on my arm, there's no telling. See, that's the way Farrah Fawcett... And the rest of them, that's the way they got their start. Oh. Now, girls, for the lucky woman that wins the date of a lifetime with the nature boy, Buddy Landel, Lance Russell, will you help me just a little bit here? Just a little bit extra, something extra here. Something for the women to hang up on their wall, and every morning when they get up, Lance Russell, they can look at the nature boy, Buddy Landel.
Okay, now that will be one of the prizes in there.
Hey, plus myself, what else do you need?
Okay. Are you gonna spring for dinner for a girl?
Lance Russell, we're talking about... Look, the Fantastics, they might rent a limousine, whatever, take the girl to the Crystal. I'm talking about my brand new Mark 7 that cost me $30,000, and I'm going to the Waldorf. I ain't going to no Crystal. I'm the nature boy. I only go first class, and don't you ever forget it.
Well, there it is. Nature boy Buddy Landel with his own contest. Might be interesting to keep up with the tabs on the entries on.
That's going to be your job. I'm exclusively hiring you for that position, Lance Russell. Every day, every time we come out here on this TV station, I want you to update the fans out there and see how far ahead the nature boy Buddy Landel is of the Fantastics.
Well, there's two of the Fantastics, so there's two girls there, and I guess one girl will be a winner in your contest.
Now, I'm not going to come out here and brag on myself, all right? Now, the nature boy, Buddy Landel, is more capable than handling more than one woman, okay? But for that single night alone, I'm only one man, and I'm only going to take one girl out. I'm sorry, girls. One girl. No ties, no tiebreakers, none of that stuff. One girl and one girl only, okay? That's it.
Okay. Nature boy Buddy Landel's contest, 19 WMC-TV, 1960 Union Avenue, and it'll be Memphis, Tennessee, 38104. We're going to keep tabs on the entries for all of it.
Nature boy up above Buddy Landel there, okay?
Okay, Buddy Landel date. All right. Well, you heard Landel. Don't forget that we have the fantastic date with the Fantastics contest also. We're going to take time out. Be back with more action in the ring in just a moment.
Kevin McQueen standing in the ring right now. New face on championship wrestling, and his partner, someone that everyone's familiar with, carrying the bullwhip with him, steps into the ring. This will be a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match from Springfield, Tennessee, at 230 pounds. Introducing Kevin McQueen, and going against him, from Oil Trough, Texas, at 229 pounds, Dutch Mantel. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee's Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, we're ready for the bell, and here we go. McQueen, a youngster. As a matter of fact, he is out of the same town that Tracy Smothers.
Tracy Smothers' hometown, you're right,
yes.
Yeah. Kevin McQueen has good height, good weight. He weighs in about 230. Looks like he's in pretty doggone good shape. Oh, hey, Dutch Mantel, got to be a little surprised there, huh? Took him right down. Dutch gets to his feet. I don't know what he's complaining about. He said something to the referee, though.
McQueen, brand new in professional wrestling, and that son of a gun has laid a couple of moves on the Dutchman already, David.
He has indeed. Mantel working that left arm. A reversal by Kevin McQueen. Mantel backed into the turnbuckles. Referee steps in between them. Kevin McQueen backs away. Headlock by McQueen. Hair pulling by Mantel. There he is again. Yanked him by the hair. Pulled McQueen over to the ropes. Got him going across the ring. Planted the boot right in the stomach as he came off the rope. Ooh.
Man, man.
Wow. Did he hit him in the small of the back with that knee or what? Mantel jabbed him with that right hand, the one with the glove on it.
Going back right after that spot where he dropped the knee on Dave, double-handed him right there.
Dutch Mantel, barring the left arm, steps over on it. Minute and a half gone in this one. Kevin McQueen. Boy, Dutch really hurt him in the back. Whoa. Mantel, look out, picking him up in the air.
Maybe he
slammed him, yeah, one, two, and three. Boy, McQueen was never the same in that one after he got hit in the back by Dutch Mantel. He was holding his back from time to time throughout the rest of the match. Kevin McQueen came in here looking good early in the match against Dutch Mantel, but Dutch turned it into his favor. And you can see what happened here as Dutch wrapped it up and got the win in 2 minutes, 6 seconds. Here it is, as Dutch just picked him straight up and slammed him face first right down into the mat, turned him over, cover, count of three, and that was it.
Mantel, your winner. Let's just go ahead, Dave. Short match. Let's stick another single match right in here. And the participants are out, and we're ready for the introductions on this one.
All right, this will also be a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match. Introducing first from Memphis, Tennessee, at 203 pounds, David Johnson, and going against him from Los Angeles, California, 226 pounds, the Nature Boy, Buddy Landel. This match, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Referee Jerry Calhoun back in there.
Okay, Johnson facing enough one of these tough opponents. He's got one here in Landel, a national title holder who gives him a quick look and then turns away. Buddy Landel, good, quick, rugged wrestler, and you can see he wastes no time in getting underway on David Johnson. Just laced him with a drop kick. Boy, what a drop kick that was. See that foot right in the face, kicked his head loose.
Yeah, he unloads that drop kick in very close to his opponent. That gives him lots of spring and can uses lots of extra spring action to kick his opponent harder than if he were farther away from him.
And he doesn't tip it off either, Dave. That's the thing about Landel. Landel will fool you in that respect. Big knee to the midsection. Mares Johnson right over the shoulder and in behind, reverse face lock as he hooks around that chin, and Johnson down on the mat has never gotten unsprung. Landel didn't give him a breather, and the referee now is going to make him give him a second breather, but that's all. You notice how quick he stayed right in on top of him. Ooh. Big elbow from Landel.
Landel, as he was dropping down, did a half spin in the air. Got figure four leg lock.
He says it's the four leg lock, and that's going to take care of it to a submission hold. As Buddy Landel, he does have a good one. He clamps on a dandy, and that figure four leg lock is successful against David Johnson. Landel springs it loose and comes out the winner over David Johnson. We've got more action in the big eight-man expiration of time match coming up in just a moment.
Some more of that big action coming up. We're going to get back in the ring in just a moment. We want to remind you again, three big title matches coming into the Coliseum on Wednesday night in Evansville, and one of them is going to be a Southern Heavyweight Championship match. No time, no disqualification. Steve Keirn, Bill Dundee will be squaring it off. Bill, I don't think you read all of the contract in there.
He read it, and he read it. Did you see what it said, anything?
It's a conspiracy, brother. You know it as well as
I do. Did you see it?
Hey, they're stacking the cards against us, Bill.
The first page, it's this big, and it's in big black letters. You don't need no glasses to read that. You don't need bifocals like mine is going. But there's four pages. He says to me, sign your name on the first one. I did that. And like we said, we're not crying over spilt milk, Keirn, because we none of us like you, Jack. And we wouldn't want to be one third of nothing, because we're all our own men. You're looking at them, Daddy. Three individuals, the nature boy, the Dutchman, the living legend, and the act superstar. You know, why will that? Tell them why will that, buddy, because we run the king out of town, right?
That's exactly right. The women are starving in Evansville for the sight of some real men, and you're looking, Lance Russell, at the epitome of manhood right here. It's obvious the last time we was in Evansville, the building was sold out because of the main reason that some real men were finally in town.
That's right. We're not selling the man short that lost the last one either, Jerry the King Lawler. Great athlete, Lance.
Who?
Jerry Lawler. That's right. But he was a great athlete, and I'm saying was. He was a great athlete. Keirn, you are a great athlete, and after next week, they're going to say he was a great athlete, because Fargo and Lane can't do nothing to help you, Daddy. You're in there with me, man on man, the Southern Heavyweight Champion, the living legend, Bill Dundee, and a loser leaf tap. And you tricked me into signing it, Keirn, you and that bag of bones model, and I'm taking my spite out on you. They said it wouldn't happen the last time, but it did, and it's going to happen this time.
Well, that's the conversation coming up from Bill Dundee.
Let me say one thing. We get to Evansville, Indiana, it's going to be a clean sweep. One, two, three. And let me tell Rick Casey something. Casey, if you show up, baby, put that car in short-term parking, because it ain't going to take me long to knock you out.
Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers, the Fantastic.
Take my word, my way around.
They're followed by Rick Casey.
Match can be held without our song, and it just happens to be Waltzing Matilda. Booba, sing Waltzing Matilda.
Waltzing Matilda, Waltzing Matilda, you come Waltzing Matilda with me. As she sang, as she walked, and waited for her billy ball. You come Waltzing Matilda with me. Down came a jumbo to drink at the belly button. Up jumped the swaggy, rubbed it with glee. As he sang, as he charged, the jumbo again and struck her back. You come a-waltzing Matilda with me.
Glad it doesn't have any more verses.
Yeah, not the truth. Eight-man tag team match coming up. Should be a wild one. Expiration of time match introducing first at a total weight of 941 pounds from St. Louis, Missouri, Tony Falk. From Pensacola, Florida, Pat Rose. And from New Zealand and Mongolia, the Sheepherders, Taurus Bulba and Rip Morgan, Jonathan Boyd in their corner with a New Zealand flag going against them. Total weight 898 pounds. From San Antonio, Texas, Rick Casey. From Union City, Tennessee, Coco Ware. And from the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California, Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers, the Fantastics. Eight-man tag team match. Expiration of time, the referee, Jerry Calhoun.
Okie doke. Let's see who it is that's going to be starting out of the eight-man bell time. Here we go. Looks like Taurus Bulba starts out and Bobby Fulton, Dave.
All right, Taurus Bulba, Bobby Fulton for respectively the team of the Sheepherders and the Fantastics. Eight-man tag match. Boy, whenever you have one of these, you end up with lots of people in the ring sometimes. Nice move by Bobby Fulton on Taurus Bulba. Bulba tried to run back into it. Bobby Fulton just went by him. Look at that. Takes him down. Fulton follows with a drop kick. Taurus Bulba down on the mat. And again, Bobby Fulton really keeping Taurus Bulba, the Sheepherder, off his feet. Tommy Rogers got that arm, and Bulba says now is the time for Rip Morgan to come to our aid. He made the tag on his other Sheepherder partner. USA the chant as the Sheepherders continue to wave that New Zealand flag around the ring. Jonathan Boyd carrying it. Tommy Rogers. Whoa, Morgan reverses Rogers. Rogers ducks under the clothesline, and another one. Presses him down to the mat. Shoulders are down. He can't make him stick for a count. Rogers with a drop kick. Look at Morgan flying through the air as Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton have really showed the Sheepherders here how they can move around the ring and keep their opponents moving in ways they don't want to go.
Tag. Chanting that bloody USA. How do you expect the Sheepherders to concentrate?
Request from Jonathan Boyd, I'm sure, will go unheeded. Pat Rose is...
This is a bloody handicap match. The Sheepherders are handicapped by two bloody Yanks.
No handicap match. Four men on the side here. That's Pat Rose flying through the air. And Rick Casey showing him how to do it. Jonathan Boyd is most unhappy with the performance of his team so far. Pat Rose having no better luck than the Sheepherders against him. He sends Tony Falk in there. Falk out of St. Louis, Missouri against Rick Casey from San Antonio. These two have faced before. Matter of fact, Falk lost two matches in one day on Championship Wrestling to Rick Casey. Reversal by Casey, fires Falk into the ropes. And off of there, he just dumped him over the back, follows with a drop kick, and Tony Falk back on his feet, reaching for a tag. He's in the wrong corner. Casey got the tag. This is Bobby Fulton. Fulton presses down on the left arm. Tag made, Tommy Rogers. Off the middle rope. Upper arm across the upper arm of Tony Falk. Rogers makes the tag. Bobby Fulton coming back in. Falk pulling hair. Bobby Fulton fired into the rope. Shoulder butt. Falk goes down to the mat. Fulton back in control. The action fast and furious here. Tony Falk looked like a fist, partially blocked here by Pat Rose, but that's the way it looked from this vantage point. Falk drops down with a lower leg across the throat. Bobby Fulton whipped into the ropes. The body slam on Fulton. Fulton moves out of the way. Bobby Fulton taking control again. He makes the tag on Tommy Rogers. Falk off the ropes. Fulton slams him, leaves him there. Rogers off the rope, covers. One, two, they got it.
Not just anybody. A Yank lost, not the Sheepherders. We'll win that tournament.
Well, Jonathan Boyd making the point that it was not one of the Sheepherders that got pinned, but it was a member of his team that got pinned in 4:07, and they lose that first fall in the expiration of time match.
Yeah. Yeah, you can get away from anybody you want to in an awful hurry, as he did. He just left Falk out there on his own. He's the one that lost it. We didn't lose it. So, there it is, the first fall. We got to check our time, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Entertainment keep you in touch with the latest.
We have cranked the time right down to the wire.
We are out of it. The Fantastics putting together the victory for their team along with Coco Ware and Rick Casey.
Yeah, it turned out to be an excellent one, and I wish we did have more time for a couple of falls. We do not. Be looking forward to seeing you next week. Hey, keep that fantastic date with the Fantastics in mind. We'll have more on it next week. For Dave Brown, Lance Russell saying bye-bye, everybody.
Announcers on this program are selected and paid by parties other than this station, namely the promoters of championship wrestling.